Well, it's about that time again to get into some more training. So now this is the part of the video series where we're going to start focusing more on the things that you'll need to know if you really want to get these projects moving along and not just collecting dust on your desk. Now, getting to know room components and learning some basic AutoCAD commands is definitely part of that, but those aren't things that we can send to the shop to be built. In the next few videos, you'll be learning how to take a new project you've just been awarded and what you need to do to get that project from A to Z. And that means laying out the project in Toolbox, creating the necessary drawings that you can send off to the customer, and also taking those drawings after they've been marked up and doing what you need to get that project ready for production. So first up, let's start a new project and learn how to draw and work with the different microvellum products in the library. Okay, you ready to go? Let's do it. Here we are back in Toolbox again. And just like always, we're gonna get a new project started. So let's open up that project tree and create a new project. We'll call this one MVU Drawing Products, Job 4. Now into the project properties, let's give it a job description. Drawing and modifying products, that works. And of course a job number. And again, the reason that we're doing this is not only to create that habit, but also some of these properties are gonna show up on some of our shop drawings as we put together a submittal package for our customer. We'll go to the project wizard and just go through the different settings on how we want this project to be built. Now, most of these settings are going to be coming in from your template. So for the most part, you're not going to have to go through a lot of the different settings in our default construction. But for this project, we are going to change it to a DAL construction. And then of course, you can see how everything works with the data behind it, right? Everything now changes to DAL. So Toolbox knows that our default construction method for all the parts are going to be a DAL construction. Under the project setup and cabinet size defaults, we'll change the base cabinet height to 32.5. Put an 1.5-inch countertop on that one. So the base cabinet height only includes the toe kick and the cabinet height. Countertop is separate. We'll change the depth and also the tall cabinet depth. Depth per cabinet height we'll leave alone, and same for the other settings. Into the additional construction, change that toe kick assembly to ladder style. So that means this will be an additional product that we'll have to add after the cabinets get added to the drawing. Global variable is another area that you're not going to typically have to go into often, since this should be set up in your template the way that you want your cabinets to be built and machined. But we are going to make a change here to the base cabinet backs. So we can turn this to a thick back, and it's going to look to our 3/4 material in our material file. Now into our toe kick general settings. You'll notice here that we have the toe kick assembly in red, so that's letting us know that's coming from the project wizard. You'll see some other names inside of these global variables that will also be in red, and it's just again letting you know that those are controlled by the project wizard. So if you wanted to make any changes, you'd go back to the wizard to do that. Let's change our toe kick front offset for our base cabinets. As you can see, we select that value, go into our text box above it, and that formula you see is just a conversion formula, so it's okay to overwrite that. All it's doing is using the correct units, whether or not we have an imperial or a metric library. So we'll go ahead and put a 3. And make sure whenever you enter something in this text box that you're hitting OK to accept that change. And do the same thing for the tall cabinets. Again, it's OK to overwrite that formula, and then make sure we hit OK. We'll save this and go into the project specification groups. Now we're going to talk about these specification groups a lot more as we get further on into working in these projects. But for right now, I just want to go ahead and delete this one spec group that we're not going to be using. And that's that unitless decorative laminate. And inside of that spec group, it has different components. Now the components are listed on the right, and Toolbox is just letting us know that if we delete this one group, that the components are going to be deleted along with it. And because we're not using this group, that's fine. We can go ahead and say yes. Now let's rename the spec group Imperial Decorative Laminate. We'll just call this PO1 Solid. So all the cabinets that are inside of this project are going to be assigned a specification group. Now, because we only have one, they're only going to be assigned to this group here. And then, of course, all the components inside of that group is what those cabinets look to for the information on how to draw and be constructed. Now, under Toolbox Setup, we're going to go to the wall setup and make sure that we set up our walls for this entire project. So if there's any changes that you want to do to your wall thickness or your default wall height, you can do that here. We're going to change it to 5 and change the height to 8 feet. Now creating a new room. Remember, just right click on that project folder and create a new room. Open it up using our selected template, and now we're ready to get to work. So basically what this exercise is about is taking a project that we've just been awarded from a customer and needing to get some shop drawings going so we could submit it to them and get that green light to proceed so we can move forward. So let's pretend this is kind of like a rush job. We're working with limited information. They need to get this job done ASAP. So we got to get them some shop drawings, get it turned around and out to the shop to be built. And this is what they're asking us to build. So just a simple run of cabinets. We got the tall on the left side, a few base cabinets next to it. And also we have that wall that should look familiar from our previous video. There we have our window that we'll need to accommodate for. And then taking a look at these shop drawings, most of these properties have already been set up in the project, but we'll take a look at the widths that we can work with here. Set them all up at 28 inches wide. And then we have that 85 inch countertop. Okay, so that's what we're gonna draw. Now let's go ahead and start adding some products to this drawing. Under draw room components, we're gonna pick our 000 point to start this wall. Give it a length of 10 feet, hit enter, and we can get rid of that dotted polyline. Now let's open up our prompts. You can see on the wall options that we have the correct thickness and the height. Now we'll go into the window options and give it a quantity of 1. Just make it a drywall hole for now. New window width and height, give it 42 and 24. And the distance from the left side will make 30. I find it a little bit easier to lay out these cabinets from a top view, so we'll change that back. Now, before we get too far along in adding these products, I just want to talk about this wall really quick. So if yours looks a little bit different and you're showing that dimension, it's just because I have the setting turned off under the toolbox options to add the 2D plan tokens to my 3D objects. So we'll go back in there. I'll turn it back on and show you quickly what this wall does when that's on. If I redraw the selected product using the button from our custom tool strip, now it's given us that dimension and changing the view. We'll hide the 3D object and you can see that we have the 2D plan rectangle below it. So that's what it's doing. It's giving us some 2D plan tokens. So if we wanted to draft without 3D in these drawings, so it'll still show us something in 2D so we know what we're working with. Now back to the top view and we can start adding these products. Under the Draw Products tab, now it's going to start off the master cabinets. We'll go to the drop down list and change that. Go to our frameless cabinetry and under tall cabinets, select our tall 2-door. Then right click, show options, and we'll place the product on the wall using anchor left. So the left side of our cabinet's going to be the anchor point. We're going to start at that corner and then move our mouse over, give it a value of 1, and hit enter. Some of these prompts we're going to leave alone because they're coming in from the project wizard, but we'll update our width to 28. Let's give it a left and right finished end and show the construction options. And here we're going to find our finished end scribe left and right. Change that one to 1/2 inch. Now under the internal options, I'm going to check the box to add a center shelf. And here you can see that it now splits our two bays in this cabinet. We got our component insert for the bottom and then also for the top. And here you can change that center shelf position. Currently it is driven by a formula that just makes sure that it's always going to be centered regardless of the height of this cabinet. But because it's not coming from one of those project level settings, we can go ahead and overwrite this with whatever value you want. It's the ones that are coming in from the project wizard and the global variables and those other components that we got to be careful with. Let this cabinet draw. And you can see now, because we have that add 2D plan tokens turned on, there's a lot more that's now showing up on this drawing. So the dimension that comes in and the product description, that's coming in because of that option that we had checked inside of our toolbox setup. Now this may be what you want, but I'm going to go back in and turn that setting off just so all that extra information doesn't start cluttering up this drawing once we start adding the rest of our cabinets. Now we just have to redraw this product, get it back to the way it was looking before. Here's that command under the Modify Products tab. It's also in the custom tool strip, so select either one. And now to pick our drawing style. Now we're back to clean drawing with just the product showing. Change it to a top view again. Go back into our draw products, now into our base cabinets. And we'll pick the base 2-door. And place the product next to the other. and we're going to change this quantity to 3. Now remember, these prompts control all these three cabinets that are coming in at this time. So we can change the width since we want them all to be the same size, but just make sure that the other settings that you turn on, you do want them for all three cabinets. We're just going to make sure that we have our thick back turned on, which it is. That's good. Came in from our global variable, so you can see how that's working. And under the internal options, we'll change our adjustable shelf to a fixed. The last thing I want to do is going back into our main tab and unchecking add countertop. This way, we don't have one individual countertop drawn for each cabinet. Now that is also a global variable that we can change, but for now, we'll just do it at the local level. So there we got our three cabinets. Now we'll have to go back into the prompts and make some other changes, but that's pretty quick. Select this one cabinet at the end, make sure we have that finished end turned on. And again, the reason we want that is not only for the material that it's going to be using, but also for our shop drawing, we want to make sure that we have that text indicator letting us know that it is a finished end or FE. Okay, well, there's really not much else that we need to do to get this drawing completed and ready for the next step in this drafting process and submit it to the customer. We'll add the countertop product and finally add the two toe kicks to finish off this run of cabinets. With the countertop again, we're going to place it next to another cabinet. And this is also going to be associated on this wall since the tall cabinet is, and now Toolbox knows we want this countertop to be also. Double clicking in the cell to give us the length that we need. We'll add another inch to that. And the depth was fine because that came in from our project wizard. Now for our toe kicks. Now the toe kicks will be found under the base cabinet accessories. Here you can see we have our toe kick base product. And this one will be easy. We're just going to fill the wall up with products, giving it a distance from the left and the right side and updating the quantity. So from the left side, it'll be 2. And from the right side, since I don't know, we're gonna double click in that cell and do our little trick or point to point trick. Let's give it a 7. Let's add another inch to that, makes it 8 and change the quantity to 2. Gives us the product width that we want. We're gonna have to wait to turn on our finished ends. So let's just hit okay, let them draw, and then we'll go back in and do that. Left finished end for that one. So now I think it's ready to go. You can see as we orbit around, everything's looking right. Both of our finished ends are turned on. Oh, wait, but hold off, not too fast. We just got an email from the customer letting us know, hey, I hope it's not too late, but we need to make a slight change on those shop drawings. So now the next part of this video is going back into the drawing and making some changes, updating the size of the tall cabinet so we don't have any conflict with the window, and then also adjusting everything over so the layout looks correct for our shop drawings. After we get that done, we'll set up a new drawing area, drop in some uppers, and from there we can prep our drawings and get them ready to send off to the customer. We'll start off by going into the prompts of this tall cabinet. Now changing that width to 25. Now into the Modify Parts tools to rearrange these base cabinets. We're going to use the bump product command. So keep selecting the product and then the product to bump to. Now, of course, spacebar would also work just to repeat that last command. Now that we have that positioned the right way, see our toe kick is hanging off the end. So we got to make a change there. We can update this width. Now, if we didn't remember exactly how much we took off of that tall cabinet, double click in there gives us a value, and doing the math, we'll change it to 52. Okay, so now I think that one's ready to send to the customer. We'll wait till we get it back. When they let us know, they'll want to make some other changes. Okay, so now for the other set of cabinets that they decided they wanted. So this is just a set of upper cabinets. They didn't give us a lot of information other than the fact that they wanted them to be 3 feet high and that the little storage room they're going in has the length of one wall that's about 8 feet, they said, and the other one's about 5 feet with a little return wall on it. We're gonna start with this polyline, adding our walls. And now because we didn't make any change to the project wizard for our upper cabinet height, I'm going to go back in there before we start adding these cabinets. If we started to add them now, they'd all be coming in at 30, and I don't want to have to go into each one and make that change. So we're doing it at this project level. So now all the upper cabinets that we add to this project are going to come in at 36. Let's make sure we save and close. Back into our drawing. We use the upper two-door cabinet and fill the wall with products. Just like before, the distance from the left side, distance from the right side, upper cabinet depth plus a filler. Change that quantity to 3 and let toolbox fill up that wall with cabinets. Okay, same thing for the next wall. This time we'll use the upper one door cabinet. Distance from the left side, upper depth plus our 2-inch corner filler, and the right side we'll give it 1.5 inches on that wall filler. Quantity 3, that looks good. Since it's just a one door, 14.5, that's a good size for that. Now we got our cabinets drawn. We'll put something in that corner. Now the corner filler is a product that's found in our master corner cabinets accessories category. It's a corner filler with cleats and it can be used for a base, tall, or an upper. So you'll see how this product works. First placing the two walls that it's going to be on. And now you can see it's looking to some of the base cabinet settings. Check the advanced options. Go in there. Now we can change the type to an upper. And back to our main. All those settings have changed. Now it's looking to those upper product settings. Turn off flush with face. I want it to be set back and flush with the cabinet box, not with the door. Turn off the edge banding, since most of that's going to be hidden. And hit OK. Okay, so just looking at this, there's a couple things that I don't want. I don't need those little return cleats. So back in there into our prompts and into the middle, left side options and right side options, change that to no cleat. The construction options, we can check that. I do want to make sure that we have a bottom return on this, so we'll check that box. And the prompt below is letting us know that if we check this, that it'll use a finished material. So I want it to match the upper bottoms. So yes, we'll check that to have a finished material. Okay, now let's just keep going through these cabinets, updating the prompts to make sure they're exactly how we want them to be built. Change the swing of the door on this one to right swing. Now into the next cabinet, updating the filler width. If we didn't remember again that we left ourselves 1.5 inches, we could just double click in there and gives us that value. Base options on this one will also change to a right door. And that should be good. Let's change our view and take a second look at this, make sure we got it, see if there's anything else we need to do. And I can see that we have on our left side there, that's not going to work because we've got the hanger notch turned on, which means it's not a finished end. So we'll go in there and make that change. Okay. After we orbit around, kind of got ourselves back into position. And sometimes, you know, when you use this orbit command, it's a good idea just to go back into your standard views since the orbit turns it into a custom view. So I'm going to go and change it back to Southwest isometric. And yeah, I wanted a top return on that one. We don't want anything falling down in that hole. Turn on this left side finished end here for cabinet 108. And I say that's good to go. So this stage of the drafting process is done. We got all our products in there. You can see our upper bottoms look good. We have our finished material. Now we can't be totally certain just by changing our view to realistic. We want to double check our material file, but that comes as we get closer to preparing this project for production. So for now, that wraps it up and we can move on to another training exercise. Thanks for watching and I'll meet you back here for our next video.